As we enter high summer, here we come with some summer bounty here at 50 Faces Podcast, as we launch series 4 that is bursting with wisdom and insights. Because life is not linear, these stories are not linear either, and they stress the power of the individual. Hear from an introvert who found her calling in connecting with people on private wealth, a pensions expert whose entire career has been driven by members first, a legendary business builder, and a private credit expert forging her own path, among other luminary guests. We start with asking about the arc of the investment world.
I think that the asset manager of the future is going to have to figure out how to customize very specifically. This is actually, I think, a trend that's societal. I don't think it's just limited to asset management. I think now people are looking for much more individualized tastes. The investments people make are increasingly becoming part of their personal brand.
Then look to the evolution of private wealth and what matters.
It's my ability to relate and connect. I bring people into rooms. I connect people. And I feel like that's what our profession needs.
The big shift is that women are going to be inheriting two-thirds of the nation's wealth within the next 6 years, which is absolutely incredible. This has never, ever happened before. Right now, we're at one-third of the nation's wealth, and it's going to be setting to double. Women distrust financial services. They don't feel comfortable. They don't feel confident. The experience has not been positive for them overall.
We talk about the development of institutional portfolios.
We're 45% funded. In terms of our asset allocation approach, certainly total return is important, but given the fact that we are an underfunded public pension plan, cash flows, especially in this environment, is critically important as well. We still obviously have commitments and pacing, and so ensuring that those portfolios are cash flow positive.
And overlooked areas in venture capital.
Even within the venture funding that Women's Health is receiving, it's mostly still focused on maternal health and fertility.
We hear about how our work is changing.
The only constant in our business is change. You sort of anticipate change. In some cases, you prompt change. But you know that things are going to continually evolve.
The ability to bring information together has always really been on the forefront of technology. But now you have the capability to bring together structured and unstructured data together. So you can think of numerical data in combination with textual data of nature. And now bring those pieces together to the forefront of an analyst or a portfolio manager, and that's pretty exciting.
And remember where it all starts and finishes, with a particular focus on the world of pensions.
I think that we have got to keep that member involvement, which I found personally throughout my pensions career, so positive. It's a really value additive to members, because it comes back down to members at the heart. It just reminds you who you're being a trustee for.
There's an enormous number of women in our scheme. I think it's something like 80%, and a lot of them are part-time workers as well. I think it's just important that they're aware of that. And we do encourage them to sort of really get connected to their financial future. That's the phrase that we're using at the moment, to try and encourage them to log on, see what they've got. Is it enough for you? Are you aware of what you're saving? And are you aware of what an amazingly important benefit the pension actually is?
And as always, we leave you with some words to live by.
Never turn down any opportunities for learning.
Just keep going. Just keep pushing through. Just keep pushing. I don't 100% believe that if you have a good idea and keep trying, you'll always get there. But I think more often than not, you will.
So tune in from next week to hear from these guests and more for a perfect suite of summer listening. From next week and all through the months of July and August.